Ladies and gentlemen, once again, a pleasant good morning to everybody. Welcome to another episode of the Lewis Sports Network. Once again, second straight video in the building. Make sure you hit that like button, hit that subscribe button. Make sure your post notifications are turned on. Make sure you share it on your social media platforms. Truly appreciate it. Thank you to everybody for always taking the time to watching, liking, and sharing my videos. Definitely appreciate you guys. Make sure that post notification bell is turned on for anytime I post up videos, anytime I go live. Definitely appreciate you guys. Hope everybody is having a blessed Saturday. Hope everybody has a blessed weekend. On to the video. Ladies and gentlemen, I got a question for y'all, man. What does manipulation, what does seeking attention, and what does cocaine all have in common? I'll give you a hint. No, should I give you a hint? No. Let me let you guess for a little bit. Let me think. Can't figure it out? Give up? Okay, I'll let you know the answer. Basically, what all three have in common is they're all a hell of a drug. And that's what we're talking about when it pertains to LeBron James, because he is a master manipulator along with the cinco fans from the media. He seeks attention because he just doesn't like when the spotlight is not on him. He hates when there's no attention on him. And on top of that, it's like he's so addicted to the attention and the manipulation that he cannot stop. And the problem is what I say, once you keep doing that, you make it hard for people to appreciate you. You make it hard for people to appreciate what you've done, because you basically did what you decide to do. You know, everything is attention. I mean, remember, you have the broken hand soft cast. And then a couple of days later, he was found to be in a restaurant without a cast. You know, I think with his family members when he was on his way on vacation. Obviously, you got the whole, you always got the, and you know what's so funny? I keep asking myself, y'all remember when the media kept saying that LeBron needed foot surgery at the end of the season? Yet we're in July, about to be August, and no whereabouts or no hearings about the foot surgery. And we keep, and it's funny because a lot of LeBron's haters have been on him, have been on his behind saying, when is he going to get the surgery? LeBron, when are you going to get the surgery? Because remember, they said, you know, oh my God, his foot. You know, he got 40. You know, he had 31 in the first half, but his teammates ain't show up. His foot. All you heard of what was about his foot. Oh, now LeBron James can rest his foot, but I thought he was getting surgery. That's what the media said. Didn't the media say that LeBron was supposed to get surgery? He may need surgery on that foot. Oh, now he could get the proper rest on his foot. Because then the media's going to come back and they basically going to say, well, you know, LeBron never really needed the surgery. It was really more so rest. I'm like, but that's not what y'all said while LeBron was playing. Remember, LeBron took a whole month off after he broke Kareem's scoring record with that alleged foot injury? Because what happened was, you have to look at it this way. LeBron was very calculating. If the Lakers showed no indication that they were going to be a playoff team, LeBron probably would have sat the rest of that season. He probably would have sat the rest of the season. And maybe what he probably would have done, he probably might have come maybe like a couple of games, maybe get some reps in, and then probably call it a season. But the Lakers were winning without him when the Lakers were playing really good team basketball. Anthony Davis was stepping up, playing like the Anthony Davis that you're obviously capable of when he's fully healthy. And what happened? LeBron saw that, and he pulled off of Scottie Pippen, decided to come back, and the Lakers were able to make the playoffs. And remember, the Lakers were getting all these calls by the referees for a team that doesn't really drive the basketball, the least amount of drives out of any team in the NBA. They were getting all these foul calls and shot more free throws than any team in the league, and it helped them get into the postseason. It helped them. And so then Nick Wright decides that after LeBron beats, obviously, Ja Morant and the Grizzlies, and y'all already know I threw my shot to him and Dylan Brooks and the rest of that team, and Desmond Bane out here looking like a mini Raptor. You know, like one of those mini dinosaurs with that little face and his little muscles and his little, you know, but never mind. That's all it is. But it's funny how LeBron fans be disrespecting all those other guys. They don't say nothing about once you get to Bron. Oh, man, did they ever get in their damn feelings? But anyway, getting back to what I was saying. And, you know, Nick Wright was talking about how he ended, you know, the Grizzlies and he ended the Golden State dynasty. And I'm like, that's funny. He ended the Golden State Warriors dynasty. I'm like, okay. Nick Wright could have that, even though it's not true. Because the thing is, we won't know the Golden State dynasty is over unless the Golden State Warriors don't go back to the finals. Even if they don't win a championship. Because here's the thing, if they don't if they don't win another championship and it's like they can't get back to the finals, like they can't make a deep playoff run, see, you'll really know it's over when the Warriors can't make any more deep playoff runs. That's when you'll know it's over. When you know that they haven't won any more championships, then you know it's over. They had just finished. Yeah, because you're going to say, oh, yeah, well, the Lakers, they defeated the defending champs. And I'm like, okay, they did. Yeah, okay, give the Lakers credit. You know, I'll give them credit. But at the same time, unfortunately, they weren't able to do anything with that. You know, they ended up getting swept by the Nuggets. But getting back to LeBron James, this is why manipulation is a hell of a drug for him, because he just proves time and time again, your insecurity causes manipulation. Your insecurity creates attention. Your insecurity is so addicting that you cannot stop. And you keep making the same mistake over and over and over again. You want to be praised for the mistakes you make, and LeBron, it doesn't work that way. You can't be praised for your mistakes. There's got to be a little bit of humility. And that's kind of what I was trying to say in the last video with what Isaiah Thomas was saying when you call yourself the greatest of all time. See, there's got to be a little bit of humility. And I've said before, when LeBron was with Cleveland the first time, I thought he was the most humble superstar that I had ever seen. And I was giving LeBron a lot of praises for how he handled situations. Even when LeBron was getting criticized, like even early on in his career, you know, he handled it like a champ. And he was very humble about it. And I was just like, I said to myself, man, I really hope, this dude is so humble, man. I really hope this guy wins multiple championships and becomes a Hall of Famer. But ever since the decision, and it's funny because LeBron tried to recreate the decision 3.0. Because remember, LeBron made the first decision by going to South Beach when he decided to take his town to South Beach and made an ESPN special about it. Remember that LeBron made the decision 2.0 and decided that he was returning back home to Cleveland. And then now LeBron tried to do the decision 3.0 with this retirement where he goes, oh man, today, guys, it's your lucky day. It's your lucky day. I'm not going anywhere as of right now. As of today, you know, I'm still coming back and playing for my 21st season. So basically what you said, LeBron, is your sycophants are about to make another all-defense team for the 15th straight season. Damn. I mean, the LeBron sycophants, they're 15-0. 15 straight? That's a hell of a win streak. I mean, if they keep this up, if LeBron keeps playing, it might be the greatest, you know, one of the greatest streaks ever in the history of all pro sports, what we're talking about, not just, you know, in the game of basketball. Ladies and gentlemen, let me tell you the real reason why LeBron wants to keep playing. It gives him more attention to be talked about. It gives him the opportunity, first of all, and people don't realize that LeBron is just using Bronny for more attention. He wants to have that Ken Griffey Jr. moment, because according to LeBron, I don't know if you guys saw the Ken Griffey Jr. documentary where they were talking about Ken Griffey Jr.'s career, and remember that his father, Ken Griffey Sr., played. He played for the Yankees. He was part of the Big Red Machine of the Cincinnati Reds when they won championships in the 70s. If y'all don't know who the Big Red Machine was of the Cincinnati Reds, those are one of the greatest baseball teams of all time that had Joe Morgan, Dave Concepcion, that had Johnny Bench, that had Pete Rose. I mean, I could go, I mean, they had freaking Tony Perez. That team was stacked. But my point is, Ken Griffey Sr. was on that team. And what I'm basically trying to tell you guys is he wants to have that moment. You see how LeBron wants to coach. LeBron wants to own a team. He's taking all these shots at Michael Jordan because Michael Jordan owned a team. LeBron wants to own, to say, I'm a better owner than you because I could lead my team to championships, to a winning organization. He wants his son in the NBA to say, look, Jordan, your sons were failures. They didn't make it to the NBA. My son did. He's trying to be Ken Griffey Jr. as if to say, I wish I could play against my son or play with my son to have that father-son moment. As if to say, Michael Jordan, you never got to have a father-son moment with your kid. You didn't get to play against your kid. You didn't get to play with your kid. That's what LeBron is doing. And also the most important thing, LeBron is trying to avoid, in my opinion, what's going to happen when he retires. And that it's not only that, listen, father time is undefeated no matter what. He's afraid of what's going to happen when the secrets are going to come out. And LeBron is afraid that he is not going to be as relevant. Because you have to remember something. Down the line, there's going to be a thing to where there's not going to be able to be a time where the next generation talks about the next greatest player in their eyes to ever play basketball with whatever they accomplish. They're going to say they're better than LeBron James, just like how LeBron fans are doing with Jordan and how he played in the Week era. The same thing is going to happen with my LeBron James when he retires. They're going to say LeBron played in the Week era. And the LeBron old heads, see what I said there? The LeBron old heads will then come out like Jordan old heads are defending Michael Jordan. It's going to be the same thing. Nothing different. You're going to see. That's what's going to happen. So nothing new there. But like I said before, man, LeBron is doing all this manipulation, all these insecurity, all these attention-seeking tactics because his time is coming to an end and the league is trying to push him out because they're pretty much tired. Adam Silver has tried his best to help him and it's not working. And basically what's happening at this point is LeBron is realizing that they're pushing him out and he's doing everything he can to make sure that he stays relevant. And this is despite the fact that LeBron is one of the most famous athletes in the world. Because think about it also. LeBron James wants his jersey retired by the Los Angeles Lakers. He's probably thinking to himself, I could probably get 23-6 retired because I used both numbers in my time with the Los Angeles Lakers. Just like how Kobe got his numbers 8-24 retired for the Los Angeles Lakers. That's the problem. LeBron is doing his best to try to erase Kobe's legacy. He's trying his very best. As if to say, this is why you think he was mentioned as one of the five most important and greatest Lakers of all time by Jeannie Buss. You know, and I talked about this already. Which is why I'm going to come in and make another video and I have to talk about the great Jerry West and why I think, to me, he should be one of the top five greatest Lakers. But we know why that's not the case. But he should be the top because, to me, he was the most influential and impactful Laker of all time. I mean, Irvin Magic Johnson deserves to be there. Kareem, Kobe, Shaq, they definitely deserve to be there. And the thing is, I can name a lot of greater Lakers than LeBron. We made many Laker videos on that. But still, the bottom line is LeBron, it's like he doesn't want to be associated with the Cleveland Cavaliers, despite the fact that he calls himself the kid from Akron. And always talks about that 52-year drought of winning the city's only championship. And I said, if you really cared about the city of Cleveland, you would have never left. Twice, which you did. I understand the first time, not the second time. I really don't. So ladies and gentlemen, this is your boy Lewis with another one. Let me know what you guys think in the comments. Bless up, live, laugh, love. Thank you guys for watching.